Hi guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So in today's video, I have a lot of interesting news items such as annual survey of education report. So ASER report has been released recently and we will be covering that in detail. So apart from that, I have also put various kinds of news, various kinds of reports in this session. So do listen to me very carefully till the end, and now let's begin the session without wasting any time. But those who are coming for the first time, do subscribe to this channel and hit the bell notification so that you get the latest updates about the channel. And also you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes and you can ask your queries there. So this is our first question. Which organization has released the On Women's Back India Inequality Report 2020? Quite an important report it is, and it has been released yesterday only. So guys, can you tell me that which organization has released this? So the answer to this question is option E, Oxfam India. So this organization has released this report. Do remember the name of the organization as well as the name of the report. Now, what is the major fact that this report mentions? Guys, do you know that women and girls of India spend around 3.26 billion hours of their day on unpaid domestic work? So this is such a quiet and shocking number, that 3.26 billion hours. Now you would be thinking that it is an impossible number. How can it be? So guys, relax. I'm talking about the whole population of women and girls which are there in India. So collectively, Indian women and girls spend 3.26 billion hours on unpaid domestic work on every day. So this is the one major finding of this report. Apart from this, the report also states that Indian women contribute only 17% to the national GDP, which is quite a low number in comparison to the world's average. So the world's average is 37%. And Indian women contribute only 17%. So now it is high time for India that women should be encouraged, should be empowered in the education as well as in the professional business segments. So that's the second major fact. Now guys, you would be amazed to know this thing, that even the sub-Saharan region, which is very backward in terms of social development, is also ahead of India in terms of GDP contribution. So sub-Saharan African women contribute around 39% to the region's GDP. So now it's really embarrassing for India, and it's also the high time that India should wake up to the women empowerment and promote education as well as entrepreneurship among women on the actual ground. So that's all for this report, and now let's discuss the second question. What is the enrollment rate of boys in government school in 2020 as per the latest annual state of education report, which is ASER survey? So this is ASER or ASER, you can pronounce it either way. So this survey is released by Pratham NGO. So quite an important aspect of this news. Remember the name, ASER NGO. And what does this survey assess? It assesses the level of education in rural India. What is the level of education? At which level does this report assess the level of education? It is at the school level. Five to 16 years children are being assessed in this report. Now in 2020, it was for the first time that this survey was conducted on phone. So that was the first time for Pratham itself that it conducted the survey on the mobile phone. Now guys, you should know that how many states were covered in this report. So 26 states. 26 states and 4 UTs were covered. 59,215 children. So this is the number of children that were assessed under this report. So these are the facts related to ASER report 2020. 2020. Now the focus of 2020's report was on online education. That's why this report holds a major significance, because we are talking about, first of all, we are talking about online education, and secondly, online education in rural India. So how much online education has penetrated, has access in the rural area, that was the focus of this report. That is why this is very important. Do pay attention to the things that I am telling you in this report. Now guys, in order to understand this report better, I have divided the report into three segments. So we will be discussing the details of those three segments later on, but for the time being, let's discuss the answer of this question. So the enrollment rate of boys in government schools in 2020 was 66.4%. So this is the number for enrollment of boys. Now why is it important? That you will understand when we come to the third segment of this report. So let's first discuss the first segment, and I hope that you are clear with the facts about this report. So here, the first segment is about the online education. So this picture is from the Hindu, and this picture tells us about the real scenario of online education in India, that only 11% of the children enrolled in both private and government school were pursuing online classes. So this is a very meager number, that only 11% of the students were pursuing online classes and 21.5% were using videos or recorded classes. So this means that only 1 in 10 had access to live online classes. So this is a very low internet penetration. This is a very low level of digital education, and it needs to be increased. Now, apart from this, what is the positive fact here? The positive fact is that the number of smartphone holders in rural India has increased from 36.5 to 61.8. So basically it has doubled in the span of 2 years, 2018 to 2020. So in the span of 2 years, smartphone users in rural India, which means that people having smartphones, the students having smartphones, the households with students having smartphones, has increased to 61.8%. So that's all for the first segment. I hope that you will remember the data mentioned here, and don't worry about this picture, because the facts mentioned in this picture have been put out, have been put in this figure as well as in the later slides as well. So we will be discussing these facts segment wise in detail, so don't worry. Okay, so this is the second segment, which tells us about the status of learning at home. So how much students are learning at home, or are they learning at all? So that is the thing, that is the second segment that ESSER reports tells us. So parental level of education and the resources with parents obviously matter for the students. If the parents do not have that kind of resources and they do not encourage their children to study, then the students are not supposed to study. So they will never study. So that is why the level of education and resources played by the provided by the parents also matter. And almost 40% of the low education families did some learning activities even without receiving any learning materials at all. So why is this important? This report tells us about the education level of children. This fact is important, that 40% students, 40% parents with low level of learning, even they encourage their children to do learning even without any kind of learning material with them. Next fact is, 2/3 of the rural children nationwide had not received any learning material or activities at all. So this is shocking, because many states have launched their online portals, online websites to provide online education, but still 2/3 of rural children nationwide were devoid of any kind of learning material. So they did not receive textbooks, online books or online audios or videos kind of things in order to get their learning. Next fact is, 20% of rural children have no textbooks at home, and the rest 80% children have textbooks, and out of these 80%, majority children belong to government schools. So 84.1 children belong to government schools, 72.2 are in private schools. And these percentages are derived from the 80%. So do remember this thing. Now, across state, every state has provided the textbooks, but only three states, Rajasthan, Telangana, and Andhra Pradesh, the proportion of children with textbooks in these three states fall below 70%. So out of these three, Andhra Pradesh, you can see that it has performed the worst in terms of providing textbooks to the children in the state. So that's all for the second segment. I hope that it is clear. Now let's discuss the third segment. It is very important. State of school enrollment, quite important. It found that 5.3% of rural children aged between 6 to 10 years had not yet enrolled. Quite an important figure it is, can be asked in the examination, be it phase 1, be it phase 2 or interview. So do remember this figure, that 5.3% of rural children aged between 6 to 10 did not enroll this year due to the pandemic. So that is why this is important, and in 2018 the number was 1.8%. So this is the drastic increase. So that is why this is very important. About 10% of the 6-year-olds are not in school. So 10% of the children who were supposed to be in school, who were supposed to be enrolled in the primary education, they are not enrolled. So this number is also important. And there is third fact, among 15 to 16 year old students, enrollment levels are slightly higher than 2018 level. This is not that very important, so you can skip this fact for the time being, but do remember these two numbers. Okay, now the next fact of importance is enrollment in government schools has increased between 2018 to 2020. Boys in government schools, we discussed it in the question itself, so the number increased to 66.4%. Now guys, you will understand why did I put this question. So the question related to the government school was there because many students are preferring government schools. Now why are they preferring government schools? Is it not only because the infrastructure and the facilities of government schools have increased, but the reason is that the private schools in rural areas have closed due to the pandemic, due to the economic crisis they were facing in the rural area. So that's the main reason of preferring government schools more. Girls in government schools, so the number increased from 70% to 73% in 2020. Quite an important number, so do remember these facts. And here this report ends. I hope that you have understood the facts clearly, and in case you have not understood, then do mention it in the comment section below. Now let's move on to the third question, which is, what is the worth of line of credit announced by India for Central Asian countries during the second meeting of the India Central Asia Dialogue? So the first dialogue was organized in 2019, and this is the second edition of this Central Asia Dialogue, India Central Asia Dialogue. And in this dialogue, India announced to give a line of credit of 1 billion to Central Asian country for their infrastructure and development purposes. That's all for this news. Nothing much to be discussed here. But just remember the number, the amount of line of credit, and the addition of this Central Asia Dialogue. Next question is interesting. So, on which rocket will ISRO launch its EOS-01 satellite? So, EOS stands for Earth Observation Satellite, which is going to be launched in November. So, this Earth Observation Satellite will help the ISRO and the agencies of India to keep a track of agriculture, forestry and disaster management plans. So plan their activities in agriculture, forestry and disaster management. So this is the purpose of this Earth Observation Satellite. Now it will be launched along with 9 other satellites. So these were the facts surrounding this satellite. Now on which rocket will it be launched? So it will be launched on PSLV C-49 rocket. So do remember the name. and it will be launched from Satish Dhawan Space Center, which is in Andhra Pradesh, Sriharikota, Andhra Pradesh. Now I have told you every fact related to this news, but one fact is remaining, and that is the full form of PSLV. You will be telling me in the comment section below. So the PSLV is quite an important rocket. Is a quite an important launch vehicle of ISRO. So do tell me the full form of PSLV in the comment section below. Next question: which state has launched Sumangal portal to promote inter-caste marriages? Quite an easy question it is, because here the purpose is given, Sumangal is to promote inter-caste marriages. Now which state has done so? It is Odisha. Option A, Odisha. Quite an easy question. I don't think any kind of explanation is required here. So I am moving on to the next question. Which bank has signed a loan agreement of 1 billion with Japan Bank for International Cooperation for financing the Japanese automobiles in India? Quite an important question it is. Now, the things to remember from this question is the amount, the organization, and the purpose. So we are clear with this, that 1 billion loan agreement has been signed by an Indian bank with this Japan Bank for International Cooperation for financing the Japanese automobile companies or the dealers which are present in India who are dealing in Japanese automobile. So in order to give them loans, this loan agreement has been signed. Now which bank is it? So it is the largest bank of India. Now I know that you have guessed the answer. So who is the largest bank of India? It is State Bank of India. So the State Bank of India has signed this agreement with the Japanese bank. Now, a minor fact here is that this Japanese bank will provide 60% financing of this $1 billion, and rest 40% will be provided by the other Japanese banks that are participating in this loan agreement. So everything is clear here. Now my question for you is that you have to tell me the MD and CEO of, not MD and CEO, chairman exactly. Chairman of State Bank of India, because he has been recently appointed. I guess in the last month he was appointed. So do tell me in the comment section below that who is the chairman of State Bank of India. Now here my session ends. I hope that you have really liked it. And in case you have any kind of doubt in understanding anything, do mention it in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching the video. Do come back tomorrow as well.